In version 14, we've added a new option here under the membership menu to search, which pops out the options by phone or by email. The functionality in both are the same, so we're going to look first at email. It displays a list of all known email addresses found here in membership, and the text field at the top of the screen does a partial text search as you type, limiting the list down to only those email addresses that contain the letters you typed in. So typing an S will remove a bunch of people from the list, and then typing an A, that's leaving only Alfred Salinas, and you can see in his address the SA is not at the beginning or the end of the email address, it's here in the middle, so it's clearly doing a partial text search. And double-clicking this record, since it's a personal email address, meaning assigned to his personal profiles record, that will open the Maintain Personal Profile screen. And we can close this now and go back to Membership and Search, and this time we'll choose By Phone. And we'll demo this quickly to show it's working the same. Searching here for 4123 finds Yvonne Davis's work phone. And if we clear that search and type 85, you'll see that it's returning all the numbers because it's ignoring all of the formatting, the parentheses and spaces and or hyphens or dots and all of those things. So the area code for all these numbers end in 8, and the next digits are all 555, so a search for 85 matches every number. So while not specifically related to the new search by email or phone utilities, let's also take a look at the contact list. This is accessible by pressing the F3 key on the keyboard. The search functionality in this form is still just looking at the last name and first name, but you can easily look up somebody's contact information using this screen. It has gotten a facelift here in version 14. First off, the shortcut letter buttons here along the right are much bigger, and they'll also be disabled if you don't have any names starting with that letter. So clicking a letter button just scrolls through the list to find the first entry of a person whose last name starts with that letter. The search functionality basically does the same thing. If the name you are searching for isn't currently in view, it will scroll the window over to show that name. So resizing this window also allows you to include a lot more names in view. And in version 14, we also added the ability to maximize this window, so you can fill the PowerChurch window with this contact form. But let's scroll the view all the way to the right and then search for CUNN, and you'll see that just scrolls back to view Alan Cunningham. One last thing that was improved on the contact list screen here in version 14 is that the shared family email addresses are also included in this list, as well as the other personal and family contact info.